Mark Rogers TV talking Michigan football, and the best way to do it is to bring in Steve Dace from Michigan Podcast. Please join him on YouTube. Michigan Podcast underway about 12 weeks ago. It's been a rousing success, Steve. How you doing today?
I'm doing well, Mark. Good to see you. Season is just around the corner. Our long national nightmare is almost over.
College football season. It's limited. It's a limited window. If you like the NBA, it goes on forever. Major League Yes. Baseball, all these other sports, even the NFL is another 6 weeks longer. College football is a precious window from September through just the first week of December. And then, of course, bowl season. Got a chance to listen to Jim Harbaugh's latest comments about Michigan football practice. Running backs, offensive line, wide receivers, tight ends, defense, everything was good or very good. The only one comment that he made that was a bit on the, not negative side, but in kind of a funny sort of way, in a reporter's comment leading him into the positional unit that's been upgraded the most, being the offensive line, he said, well, I don't know, because they can't block the defensive front. So he goes, I hope they are, but I can't tell right now. So your assessment of the personnel at this point?
Well, I think that gets, before we get to specific personnel groupings, I think that gets to two major themes for fans, whether you're a Michigan fan, Mark, or a fan of any other school, is when you start reading about camp reports and the coaches talk, when you have media days or the coordinators come out, you know, several times throughout camp and give updates or players, a couple things to keep in mind. Number one, when you hear about a young player flashing early in camp, it's early, okay? So, you know, they may come in, they may have that eye of the tiger. They might have been Clubber Lang in the offseason for Rocky III. They're doing chin-ups on a pipe, you know, while everybody else is working out at Gold's Gym, right? You know, they got an edge. You want to find out if that young player is still being mentioned when we get to week three, week four of camp, because sooner or later, when you have enough reps and the heat and the temps kick in, water will reach its level, right? So when you hear about that young player flashing early in camp, pump the brakes a little bit and wait until we get into the dog days of August to see if their name is still coming up as number one. And number two, when you have a group that hasn't proven itself on game day, and I'll use my favorite team here that we're talking about as a specific example. When I hear Michigan's defensive line is dominating, I believe it. Why? Because we've seen the way they've recruited there. Maurice Hurst was Michigan's best defensive lineman down the stretch last year. Todd McShay just ranked him the number one interior defensive lineman for the 2018 draft. Rashawn Gary was the first player ever to be ranked number one overall recruit by the three major services in the same year, ESPN, Rivals, Scout, and Scout 24/7. And so we saw Chase Winovich when Taco Charlton went down. We saw what these guys can do. So that I believe. But when you hear the freshman wide receivers are flashing, keep in mind they're going up against, in the case of Michigan, an all-new secondary. And so sometimes you don't know until you play another team, because we don't have preseason games, right? And so you don't know until you play another team if a group that is overperforming your expectations is doing so because they have developed and emerged, or are they doing so at the expense of your favorite team's opposite alter ego unit? And this is true all over the country, depending on what that question mark unit or two was for your team. When you get to this point of the season and you're hearing in the training camp, well, I mean, I think that unit's a lot better. You need to make sure you're assessing who it is they're going up against on the other side, because this is a give or take zero sum game. Whatever is being done great for your favorite team in practice on one unit is at the expense of another team or another unit from the same team.